Church, I trust the last few weeks has been an encouragement and joy gathering with others in small spaces, sharing together in worship on Sundays, sharing meals after church together. It's a reminder to us that you and I, we were made for relationships. God has designed us to love and to be loved, which is why the gospel, the good news of Jesus, brings us into the greatest love relationship you can be brought into. A love relationship with the God who made you, but also into a love relationship with each other as His people. It's a reason why you and I, we long for community, to know and to be known, to love and to be loved. COVID isolation has highlighted that for us this year. Of course, you can worship God alone, but there's something special, isn't it? When you gather with others to worship God, the experience of joy and delight is much greater, isn't it? Why? Because you are sharing what you love most with others who share that love with you. That's the reason why the final scene in the book of Revelation is God's people gathered together around the throne in worship. Not individually, not by themselves in isolation, but together as a community around the throne of God, sharing together, shoulder to shoulder, in the joy of worshiping the God who has saved them, the God who has loved them in Jesus, the God who is their highest love and treasure. The joy of worship is always enriched and greater when you share it with others around you. It's the reason why there's no such thing as a Christian without a church community. We know from Ephesians 2 that the God who has saved us by grace through faith in the Lord Jesus hasn't just saved us into a relationship with Himself, but also into a relationship with others, His people. To choose not to be part of a church community is to deny God's grace in your life if you're a follower of Jesus. It's the reason why, as a church community, if we are to experience God's work of grace, it's the reason why 1 John tells us to love each other as God has loved us in the Lord Jesus Christ. You've come to know this as a follower of Jesus. You've come to know and experience the love of God for you in the gospel. But the church community gathered is the place where that is to be lived out and expressed and experienced. Which is why we read these words in 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 to 12. Words that are very familiar to you. John says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed His love among us. He sent His one and only Son into the world that we might live through Him. This is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins." And then John says, "Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and His love is made complete in us." Church, I want to say to you, it's time to regather as God's people. We've started regathering one-to-one. We've started regathering in small spaces on Sunday. But now it's time for us to regather as God's people at GracePoint. So I'd like to let you know that as a church community, we will be regathering for Sunday church across GracePoint the week before Christmas on Sunday, December the 19th. All restrictions are on track to be lifted by then, which means everyone is welcome to praise and worship with us. So Sunday, December 19th at Burwood Christ College, at Lidcombe, our ministry center, at Granville, Knox Presbyterian Church, all our Sunday services will be opening up. That being said, I do know that there might be some of you who, for health reasons, might not be able to regather with us. I want to assure you that our live stream will continue. We want to make sure that everyone is able to continue worshiping with us. But I want you to lock that into your calendars. Sunday, December 19th, all our Sunday services are kicking off at Burwood Christ College, at Lidcombe, our ministry center, at Granville Knox Presbyterian Church. And so let me invite you to pray for us as a church community as we prepare to regather. Let me ask you to encourage each other as we prepare to regather. And let me encourage you to anticipate the joy and the delight that will come as we regather for Sunday worship together across GracePoint. Now, let me also take a moment to let you know what's happening at church as we move into the Christmas season. Lots of things are happening in the coming weeks ahead. And so here are a few things that I want you to let you know about. Put in your calendars, share it with others, join us. First up, next Tuesday night, the 30th, is our final men's ministry event for the year. And that's going to be in person at our Lidcombe Ministry Center, where Pastor Mikey Tai will be joining us from Providence Church in Brisbane. Via Zoom. If you don't know Mikey, he used to be a familiar face around GracePoint, one of our students, now a pastor in Brisbane, married to Heidi, one of the girls here at GracePoint. And he'll be taking our session this coming Tuesday, and he's going to look at what it means for men to be sons of the Heavenly Father. He's going to look at the theme of rebel sons, adopted sons. So that's next Tuesday, 8 to 9:30 in person here at our Lidcombe campus. The second thing that's coming up is Pastor Dinesh's ordination. That's taking place on Saturday, December 4th at our Granville campus, Knox Presbyterian Church. We're going to come together to recognize God's call to Pastor Dinesh as a minister of the gospel. And he's going to be ordained as a minister of word and sacrament in the Presbyterian Church of Australia. Come and encourage him. Come and support him. So that's coming up Saturday, December 4th, 11:30 a.m. at our Granville campus. That's on 14 Hutchison Street, Granville. That's Knox Presbyterian Church. Let me encourage you, come to encourage and support Pastor Dinesh and Shami. Lunch is being provided, and you will need to RSVP if you're coming. You can do that at ordination@gracepoint.org.au. The third thing that's coming up is our Gospel Laborers Annual Celebration. That's coming up on Friday, December the 10th. In the evening at our Lidcombe campus. You know, each year we celebrate what God is doing in raising up gospel workers at GracePoint, where we pray to the Lord of the harvest that He would continue raising up men and women for the work of the gospel, where we commit ourselves to supporting and partnering with our apprentices each year. And this year, we're graduating John Lee, who's finished 2 years of his ministry apprenticeship with us. He'll be starting next year his theological studies at Moore College. But we're also going to take on board a new ministry apprentice, Clement Hui, as he starts his ministry apprentice with us next year. That's coming up next Friday, December 10th, 7:30 p.m. at our Lidcombe campus, our Gospel Laborers Annual Celebration. Come and join us on that one. The fourth thing that's coming up this December is our GracePoint Christmas Carols and Picnic by Candlelight. That's coming up on Saturday, December 11th, 4 p.m., 7 p.m. at our Granville campus. That's Saturday, December 11th, 4 to 7 p.m. at Granville campus. What a wonderful opportunity to invite your friends and family along to an outdoor picnic under the jacaranda tree, out in the open, enjoying a meal and music put together by our GracePoint music team. There'll be kids' activities and a Christmas message by Pastor Elliot. And a chance as well, an opportunity as well, to sing along to carols by candlelight. And so let me encourage you to take the opportunity, invite your friends and family along to our GracePoint Christmas Carols and Picnic by Candlelight, Saturday, December 11th, 4 to 7 p.m. at our Granville campus. Now, you can find flyers that you can use to invite friends and family along to, and you'll find that at gracepoint.org.au/go/carols2021. That should come up on the link. Now, the last thing that's coming up this Christmas, this December actually, is Christmas in small spaces. This year, we are doing Christmas in small spaces. And so let me encourage you to reach out and invite others along to do Christmas with you in your home. Regulars here in our church community, friends and family, workmates, why not take the opportunity to host Christmas in small spaces, meet around Christmas around our live stream, and then have Christmas lunch together. What a great way to celebrate Christmas. What a great way to share the love of Jesus with family and friends this Christmas day. We will be streaming Christmas at 9:45 with Pastor Kamal. He's going to bring us a message on joy is born at Christmas. And you can find a digital flyer that you can use to invite friends and family. You'll find that at gracepoint.org.au/go/xmas2021. That should come up on the link as well. As usual, our Christmas in Small Spaces stream, that'll be up on youtube.com/gracepointsydney or on our website. Lots of exciting things happening in the next few weeks as we work to regather as a church community. Let's be praying for a smooth transition as we regather in person as a church community. And let's encourage each other as well as we start meeting together. And let's look for gospel opportunities that we will have this Christmas.